Hey guys, what's up? Today we'll be talking about cloud code. We'll be discussing how you can connect to your GitHub account, how you can activate your cloud code and manage it on GitHub. Cloud code gives you the chance to extend the API. We at SashiDo believe in the good practices, and that is why we believe that it's easier and better if cloud code is deployed with Git. For those of you who wonder what that gives you, here are a couple of things that we can mention. You have version control. The entire deployment process happens with just a Git push, and also we give you a private GitHub repo via which you can easily deploy. This also helps a lot for teamwork. There are different branches, pull requests, and you can also use the issues in GitHub. As you can see, there are quite a lot of benefits. So let's get straight to it and see how we can connect our cloud code to GitHub and start using it. So right after you log into your dashboard and you create your application, you need to go to the cloud code section right here. Once there, you'll see a message saying connect your account to GitHub. You just need to click on the button. I have already connected our SashiDo Video Series account to GitHub, but it's super easy and straightforward. You just need to click on the button and within a couple of seconds your app will be connected to your GitHub account. Once this happens, a new message will appear saying start your cloud code. You'll click on a button and the system will tell you that your cloud code is activating. This usually takes up to a couple of minutes. As soon as the cloud code is activated, you'll see the screen right here. This is our example cloud code. Once it appears, you know that you're done and you can start managing your cloud code on GitHub. Let's click on the button and see what happens. We are redirected to our private GitHub repository. As you notice, we have two folders, cloud and public. Our engineers have done something cool, and this was to mount the public folder of the repos so that you can host static files. Now let's see how we perform changes on GitHub. Let's, for example, perform a change in our cloud folder in the app.js file. Right now, the default function that we have is hello from SashiDo. This is the URL that we need to visit in order to verify this. Let's, for example, change it to hello from SashiDo Video Series. We need to go right here and click on the Edit this file button. We perform the change that we need. And once we are done, we need to scroll down and click on the Commit Changes button. As soon as we do it, the cloud code starts building. A message also will appear in the dashboard right here, verifying this. It needs a couple of minutes maximum to build, so let's leave it for now and return back shortly. So once the cloud code is built, this message right here appears saying that your cloud code is ready to use. You need to refresh, and it will need just a couple of seconds to refresh. We can now go check if we have successfully performed a change in our cloud code. And here it is. This is the change that we performed. Analogically to this, we can perform changes to the public folder as well. Something important to mention here is that cloud code is Node.js and you can install NPM modules. We have a couple of tutorials on cloud code, by the way, in our blog, so I'll leave them in the description of the video. There is an example for Twilio, however, the process will be identical with the other modules. Also, another thing is that you can install manually other third-party modules. This is something exclusive for SashiDo, and you won't be able to do it with other parser server providers. That was basically it for today, folks. I hope the information was useful to you. Next week, we'll be discussing the API console. Thanks for watching and see you soon. Bye for now.